Hello guys, welcome to BuddyDevelopers. I'm Naveen, and in this video we will see how you can create a directory website using Geodirectory and the theme called Blockstrap. So let's start. So in order to set up the website, we need two things: a domain name and a hosting. So domain name is the one by which your website will be recognized over the internet. For example, google.com is the domain name of Google. Facebook.com is the domain name of Facebook. NaveenGiri.com is the domain name of Naveen Giri website. So similarly, you have to decide a domain name for your website, the name by which it will be recognized over the internet. And the second thing is hosting. So hosting is the place where you put your website code files. So you can find many hosting out there, but I personally recommend Hostinger because I'm using it from last 3 years for my websites, and their plan is also good, and I've seen that they are growing very fast in this 3 years. I have noticed it. Their support is good, so you can check. I will send the link of this plan page in the description of this video so that you can click over there, and it will give me some referral to if you buy it by clicking on that link. So now I'm wondering that you have purchased your Hostinger account, and after login you get a dashboard like this. So in the domain section, if you click on domains, from here you can get a new domain. You can click on get a new domain, and here you just have to type the name of your domain. For example, your bookstores, maybe we can call it xbookstores.com. So you can see this domain is available in $4.99 per year plan, and if you buy .com, .in, .online, three variation of this domain, then it will cost you this much. It's in Indian rupees. You can check the page. It will show you based on your currency. If you are not sure like what could be the name of your domain, in that case they have a AI tool which will help you. You just have to describe your business here, and this AI tool will help you to give you the suggestion of your domain name. For example, you see, after I given this title to this AI, the AI generated following domain name for me. So once you're done with buying a domain name, the next step is to install WordPress in that domain. I already have a domain name called kitabukahisab.in. I will copy it. And in order to set up a website in this domain, I will go here in the website tab and then click on add website. So here you have several options like WordPress and Hostinger website builder, empty site. And if you already have a website, you can migrate that website by clicking on this. I want to set up a WordPress site, so I will click on WordPress. And here I will say myself and for my business. Here we have to set up a username and password. Now I will click on next. This website is does not belong to any of one of them, so I will click on other and then next. And here they have given you several suggestions that you can use, but I want a blank site, blank WordPress site. I will click on that. And here Hostinger recommending me several plugins. I don't think I need any one of them, but for the time being, all-in-one SEO is for SEO integration and WP form is for form, but I don't think we need WP form. Let's keep all-in-one SEO plugin and click on next. And here I will have to give a brand name. This is my brand name. And here you have to type your description. I'm clicking on generate. So it's a dummy text that this AI generated for me. Let's click on next. And here I will have to choose my domain. So this is the domain name. See, it's saying that this domain is registered on elsewhere. So when you using a domain name that is registered elsewhere, you will need to manually connect it to the website. Let's see. So now after this process is completed, you will see the new website is added in the website section. And if I click on dashboard, so this is the dashboard that is specifically for this website. And by clicking on this button, I will be directly moved to the admin section of this website. You can also go to the admin section by adding /wp-admin. So this URL will redirect you to the admin dashboard. So here we are done with the WordPress website setup. Now we will go to our next step for installing the theme and then Geodirectory plugin. So in the demo.ico.io, you will see different demos created by Geodirectory team. So all the demos that you see under Blockstraps are created using the Blockstrap theme. And similarly, they have created Elementor demos, Guidance demos, and the legacy themes of Geodirectory, their demos. For this video, we're going to use this directory theme demo. So directory theme is a child theme of Blockstrap theme. Similarly, the Blockstrap theme have real estate theme as a child theme, event theme as a child theme. So all these demos that you see, they are the child theme of Blockstrap, and they are freely available in wordpress.org. So we're going to use directory theme for this particular demo. So if I click on this demo link here, this is how the demo look like for the directory theme. So in this video, we will set up this demo in our website, and we will see how to customize the different templates. So let's start. So I am in my WordPress dashboard now. In order to install the theme, I will go here in the appearance, themes, and then click on add new theme. And here I will search for the theme called directory. So there are different directory themes that coming up. The one created by IOCode is the directory theme we need. So I will install this directory theme. And then activate it. So here we are, our directory theme is activated, but you will notice that we installed directory theme. Blockstrap theme is also got installed because Blockstrap is the parent theme of directory theme. So here you can read, this is the child theme of Blockstrap. So in order to use the directory theme, we need the Blockstrap. And at the top, you will also see a notice where it says to install the Blockstrap block plugin, which include all the blocks that is needed for a Blockstrap theme. So I will install this plugin too. And I will activate it. So now after we installed and activated the theme and the related plugin, here you see a new notice that says required plugin. Directory theme requires some plugin for complete functionality. Setup theme. So I will click on this button. And on the right hand side, you see that Blockstrap Builder is already enabled. And the second required plugin is Geodirectory. So I will enable this option and it will automatically install Geodirectory and activate it. Now I just have to refresh the page. There you go. You see the setup wizard for Geodirectory. So we already have a video in our YouTube channel. I will add the link in the description of this video where you can follow the complete guide for Geodirectory plugin. I have explained everything in step-wise step manner there. For now, I will just follow this setup wizard that says to select one of the map type. Since Google Map required billing to be enabled, I'm gonna use OSM map. It's a free map and almost cover all the functionality. I will click on continue. And here I have to define my default location. So I'm gonna define my default location and set address on map. So let me drag it here somewhere. Okay, so now I have defined my default location. Let's continue. So in the extra feature, it suggests us several plugins like iCode Connect. It is needed when you have the premium plan for Geodirectory. So iCode Connect help you to connect with the Geodirectory support, and also it will help you to enable your membership and also allow you several options so that you can import demos and all. So for this particular video, I'm not gonna use any Geodirectory paid feature, so I'm not installing this plugin. Instead, for uses WP, this plugin provide you an option to log in and register in the website, and also it provide user profile management. So I'm gonna keep this plugin and I will just click on install. Okay, so now the plugin is installed. I will click on continue. So at this fourth step, we have to import the dummy data. So I am selecting that 20 dummy post to be imported. Use the page template, default page template, and click on insert post. Okay, so now 20 dummy post has been created. I will just click on continue. And we are done with it. So I will just click on create your first listing. So basically here in the place section from backend, as the admin, I can create post. And in the places, I can see all the places that is created there. And now if I refresh my website in the front end, there you go. You see the website like this. You see several short codes like this GD location short code, and one of the short code is printed here, GD location meta. So these two short codes are coming from Geodirectory location manager add-on, and since we are not using that add-on, these short codes are just printing up here. Okay, so this is how you can set up the Blockstrap theme, the directory theme demo of Geodirectory. In the next video of this series, we will see how you can customize these page templates. For example, this home page, how you can customize it, how you can customize the header, how you can do customize the footer and other pages like this archive page. And I will also share some of my tips in the next video. So stay tuned. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, you can subscribe to the YouTube channel, and see you in the next video.